Welcome back to the channel, guys. So I just got to a hardware store and picked up some hose. I gotta replace a transmission line and a couple other small things. We get ready to go wheeling tomorrow, so tune in. I just got back from the hardware store and we went out there, and basically, like I said, I gotta replace one of the transmission return lines. It's leaking, so instead of actually buying the one for $35, what I saw people are doing was just replacing the hose and using hose clamps to prevent them down. And they also got a little bit of ATF for what I lose. So I'm gonna start by pulling the hose out. I don't think that's gonna be very fun, but I'll try to document as much of it as I can. Basically something I'm just trying to get done so that way when we're wheeling tomorrow, I don't lose a whole bunch of transmission fluid and end up getting stuck out in the Escada. So stay tuned. All right, guys, so what I gotta do is pull this hose. This is the one that's leaking, obviously. So there's two clips right up here. I'm having a really hard time actually getting them to unclip, so this comes off. And it goes all the way back there. And same thing, it's got two clips that holds it in the back as well. So what I'm gonna do is actually I'm gonna cut these clamps off, and then we're actually just gonna replace the hose and put hose clamps back right over it. Like I said, I got the clip off of it right here. And then here's the O hose. So it definitely looked like it was leaking from the inside. And I'll clean this off real quick. All right, so like I said, the plan is to shove this right over where these clips here. So I'm gonna have to widen that so I can get over there, and I can put two hose clamps on there, and that way that'll stop it from sliding off. Okay, so this is pretty much it right here. So I was able to, actually I heated up this hose a little bit and I was actually able to push it right over that. So I have one hose clamp holding it there, one hose clamp holding it there. So regardless of how much pressure this line is gonna be under. All right, so I got the hose put back on, wiped it down a little bit. It's looking pretty good. We'll go ahead and start it, make sure there's no leaks. We'll be ready for tomorrow.
We just filled up, hit Bi-Mart, we got all our supplies. We're heading out to Escada now. We're gonna be out the flats. I had to take the fender flares off.
Shoot!
I had to take off the fender flares because they were already rubbing with.
He don't care for our lives. He don't care for our lives. He's on the phone and driving.
I'll get back to you guys when we get out there. We're up here at the Lattie Flats. I found this little area right here, so I'm gonna run through that real quick. I'll have Brian film for us.
Half up the rim.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Alright guys, so we just got to the spot and we already got one down. So we're trying to see if we can help these guys out. And so, yeah, we'll get out, see if you guys help them out a little bit. See how it goes. Alright guys, so they said there's a bigger gravel pit up this way. So we're gonna head up there and see what we can find.
Thank you.
We're gonna head on down, probably go find somewhere we can go shoot some guns, because it's no shooting in this area. So, probably gonna head further out towards La Cicada. And I don't know how much more wheeling we're gonna do. I had a little bit of fun. Matthew over here filming for us. But, yeah, we'll see what happens, and then, yeah, maybe put in some footage of us shooting or whatnot. I don't know if you guys really care for that or not, but I'm gonna put it in anyways. Just got to the shooting area, got all the guns behind us. Brian over out here with the big dick. Got my sidearm right there. We got some targets up. We just basically rely on what we're shooting out of here. Let's see what Matthew shoots. Okay. 10 feet away, another miss. Let's see what I could do. Let's see if I can. Not too bad. We got some people shooting up over there. I gotta go put the camera up. Right, let's see what kind of damage Brian's gonna do. Hey, you can't shoot that with that. Shoot everything
yes,
else.
I can.
Yeah, kill that thing before we even get a shot at it. Big gun. Alright guys, so as you can see, it is pouring down rain. So shortly after we got to the shooting site, unfortunately it started raining, so we were actually only able to get off a few rounds. I probably shot maybe 30 rounds of the 22 and probably another 20 rounds of the 9mm. How much did you get off?
Me?
Yeah.
Were you like 80 rounds?
I got off a load.
Matthew got a load off. Brian got off about like, what, you said 80? Yeah, so we weren't there very long. It was probably like maybe 20 minutes of shooting, and then it started pouring down rain, and we weren't too prepared for that. So we just got back to town, guys. So I'm here at the Self Car Wash. Let's see how much damage we did. We didn't do too bad. A little mud on the wheels. Not a long side. Nothing in that. So I'm just gonna give it a quick rinse. Get some of the mud off the doors and the windows. I got it all nice and hosed off. The fender flares did not make it. So I
might not put those back on. I'll probably end up having to do mud guards or something, or mud flaps. But still pretty good out there. I had a great time. So I hope you guys liked the video. Tune in, share, like, subscribe. Like I said, we're gonna do a $100 giveaway at 250 subscribers. So let's get me up there. That way I can continue making more videos for you guys. I had a blast with this one. I might hit RDM tomorrow, I might not. We'll see what happens. So if I do, I'll continue this video. If not, you guys have a good one. I'll see you on the next one.